With Inworld, you can easily add intelligent AI NPCs to Unreal Engine. In this tutorial, Matt will take you through how to add Inworld-powered Ready Player Me avatars and set up triggers for them to respond with real-time, unscripted comments about things happening in the game world.
Say hello, Matthew.
Hello, everyone. It's nice to meet you all. I'm Matthew. I'm a Unreal Engine developer here at Inworld, and I'm going to show y'all how to integrate Inworld into Unreal Engine.
All right. That means I get to shut up now and turn it over to Matt.
Awesome. So to start, what we're going to do here is I have a sample project from Unreal, but you could use any project of your own to integrate Inworld. But I'll just use this as a starting point. So if you open up Unreal Engine 5 or 5.1, you can create this first person template project. We'll just give you a character, you can pick up a gun and shoot things. I like the call out there. So if you just press create here, it'll make a project. It takes about a minute to generate, so I've gone ahead and done that here. I have this just in-world project. So let's go ahead and open that up. We'll see a non-in-worldified version of the project. Alrighty, so here I have my project. I can press play. I can pick up a gun and shoot it. But it's not very interesting. There's not very dynamic characters to have conversations with. So let's go ahead and fix that. So to get in world, you'll want to go to our website. We're coming to the Unreal Engine Marketplace soon, so stay tuned for that. But you can just go to docs.inworld.ai, go to Unreal Engine, and you can download the plugin right here. To save time, I've already downloaded that onto my desktop here. So let's go ahead and add this to our project. We can do that by opening the project folder, and we'll create a new folder in here that's just called plugins. Plugins, if I can spell correctly. And we just simply drag and drop that folder into our plugins folder, and we're good to go. We'll just want to right-click the uproject file, and then select Generate Visual Studio Project Files. This will take just a little bit. And then once that's done, we can go ahead and open up this solution project. The solution takes a little bit of time to build. So again, I've prepared that already. I just have this in-world project built. But as you can see, it's exactly what we had beforehand. We'll just save time on the building steps. So if we just open up that solution, we have Visual Studio here. And if you're not super savvy in programming C++, don't worry. You don't actually have to touch the code here. You can just press this play button at the top of Visual Studio. It'll go ahead and build that for you and then bring up Unreal Editor. So it should just take a second here. All right. So we have our project template that we saw before. But now we have the Inworld AI plugin installed. So let's go ahead and get a character from the studio that we can integrate into this game. So here we have our studio. And I've gone ahead and made a workspace. I have a scene that's just called test. It just has a test character. And this character is super enthusiastic about Inworld. We just say, you know, it's a test character that's used to show demos, really hopes users enjoy Inworld. You know, the motivation is to excite people about Inworld. It really wants to be a mascot for Inworld. The one thing that is special about this character that we'll show in a little bit, it does have one goal and action that Nathan had showed off. This is just called shot. And if we look at it, the goal trigger is just shot. And then we invoke instruction to say, talk about how much getting shot hurts. And so we'll see that shortly with our character. So to integrate, it's very simple. We have a tool for it. But from Studio, all you'll need is to go here, and you'll want to select Generate Studio Access Token. Here you have this token that you can copy, and then we'll paste that within Unreal Engine to integrate the character. So here, all you just need is to go to this handy tool section, and then go to Editor Utility Widgets, and select Inworld Studio Widget. We get this menu, which I'll paste the key off on my other monitor just so you can't see my private stuff in there. But once you do that and press login and select your workspace, you can select the scene, which is that test scene that I made before in Studio, and then the API key. You'll see here that we get a few things. One, we have this assigned to current map. This creates an actor that associates the current level in Unreal with the scene listed here. So if I go ahead and do that, we get this BP in-world session controller. And it's fairly simple, and you can do it manually yourself, but it's a quick little get started tool. All it does is says, okay, let us know when the connection state changes and print it out, useful for debugging. And then over here, we just start a session with our scene that's specified and API key. It all just automatically works. If you want more fine-grained control, you can do all the blueprinting yourself around starting and stopping sessions, but this is a very quick and easy way to get up and running very quickly. So for our character, we use Ready Player Me character avatars. Just you can configure them on the studio and then import them into Unreal or Unity. And to do that, you can just press the Ready Player Me button in this widget. And it'll take about 30 seconds or so. It's getting a lot of files from online, you know, the model, the textures, etc. And they'll just download into your Unreal Engine project. So I'll just take a brief moment.
This is, of course, when we say you're not obliged to use Ready Player Me avatars.
Yes. You can use it with any character. Ready Player Me just makes it really quick and easy to get started, you know, before you've maybe done your own artwork or all that. Or if you want to use a permanent solution, that's good too. All right. So now we have these assets. We have a blueprint and we have some texture and skeletal mesh assets here. I'll go ahead and save these. And this character is all set up and ready to go with Inworld. We have this Inworld character component that's already set up with the brain name that's associated with our workspace and character from there. And we also have some playback components set on this character. Playback components, there's more documentation on the docs, but essentially this is, all right, Inworld AI has sent us data. How do we play this into the world? So something like lip syncing movement or playing audio is set through these playback types. So for this character, we just have triggers, which is the goals and action system, and the audio lip sync, which is OVR lip sync on top of the audio. So this character is all ready to be dragged into the world. So I'll go ahead and do that. I'll just place him right here. We'll zoom in a little bit. And I can get rid of this menu now since we've put in the controller and character. I'll go ahead and just angle this guy right here. All right. Now we have to set up the player. So in order to talk to these characters, we have to take in the microphone input and some other components for the character, like targeting and whatnot, so we know who we're talking to. Again, all configurable. But as you can see on our game mode, by default, we have this BP first person character. So that's the character that's going to spawn for the player to play as. That's the pawn class. So if you go to person, blueprints, we have this blueprint here. You can right click, and we have this handy dandy in-world actions tool, which can, if you have a character of your own, you can just do setup as in-world character. It'll put up a bunch of assets onto that. But the Ready Player Me character is already set up for us, but we'll go ahead and set up our player pawn as set up as in-world player. So as you can see, there's this little star icon. That means it's not saved. There's changes that we haven't saved yet. So let's go see what those changes are. So here we have a bunch of components that we didn't have before. We have our in-world player component, which is the engine behind this. And then we have the player audio capture component, which deals with taking my microphone input and sending it off to in-world to let it digest that. And then also the targeting component, which says, hey, right now I think you're talking to this specific in-world character. So again, you can subclass these, customize them, but it's a very good starting point on integrating with in-world. So if I go ahead now I should be able to talk to this character. So I'll just run up to him and say hello. Hello.
Hi there. So glad you could join me here. Let me tell you about Inworld, the amazing technology that developers use to bring their NPC to life. It's an incredible tool that is easy to use and provides a great platform for creating interactive experiences for users. With Inworld, NPC like me.
Okay,
can
I'll
come
go
alive.
Ahead and cut him off. But as you can see, he's very excited about Inworld, and I hope you all are too. The last thing I want to demonstrate is using the goals system. So we're going to do, I remember I had the this here, where we had our character test this shot. I want to go ahead and trigger this shot on the character. As you noticed, Unreal's template project provided me with a gun that shoots bullets. So I think it'd be fitting if we shot this character and had him react to that. So if we go here, I'm going to go ahead and edit him because I do want to give him some collision. By default, they don't have collision. I'll go ahead and add a capsule component. And I will make sure that it is large enough to fit on our character. Let's just kind of roughly size it. We don't have to be perfect here. About that looks good. Good enough to shoot him. Actually, make sure we get the head in there too. Cool. Now the is collision. Let's go ahead and have, we'll just do it real quick on the bullet. I open this first person projectile that Unreal provides in their template. Go to the projectile movement. And here at the bottom, we have on projectile bounce. Go ahead and add that event. Go ahead and break this because what we want to do is say, hey, if my hit actor, when it bounces, is our little test character. This isn't the best way to go about it, but it's certainly quick. Go ahead and grab the in-world character component. And then send custom event. There we go. All we have to do here is pass in shot. That's what maps to our goal. So if I compile this, let's save this projectile. When the projectile hits this capsule that's on our character, the character will get a trigger saying shot, and he should be able to respond to us.
Ouch. That hurt. I'm so glad you're excited to learn about Inworld. It's such a great technology that makes it easy for developers to bring their NPC to life. Yeah, that was pretty painful. But I'm so amazed by what can be done with the help of this amazing tech. You can make your own worlds, create custom NPC, and control them like you are a real person. It's just incredible.
Awesome. And I think that's all I have to show.
I really can't complain about this ambassador. I mean, even when under fire, he continues to extend our versions.
I made him super bubbly. That was one of the things I made him bubbly. I said just super enthusiastic. I cranked all the knobs up. So not so surprised he's okay with being shot. As long as you're using Inworld, he's okay.
If you'd like to try your own hand at Studio or use Unity and Unreal integrations, then sign up for our open beta at inworld.ai. Also subscribe to our channel to stay updated and see more use cases, tutorials, and demos. As you can see, there are a lot of ways to use Inworld to help you, and your NPCs, be at the forefront of the technology revolution shaking up the gaming industry. Thanks for watching!